Finally, in our news, Swedish pop sensation Abba made a comeback on Friday with their new album Voyage, nearly 40 years after they split up, delighting fans but leaving critics divided.
I never thought there would be an ABBA reunion. I've been saying that in interviews for years. I've been writing it in my books, you know, that's never gonna happen. So I'm just as surprised as anybody. And I'm really, really happy for them that they wanted to do it, because it's obviously, I mean, they don't need the money, so it's not about that. Well, it still feels a bit unreal, to be quite honest. You know, it's like, you know, a new ABBA album, is that really happening? But having listened to it, you know, two or three times now, I quite like it, actually. They have nothing to be ashamed of. It's been done, seen through with dignity, and it's not gonna harm their legacy or anything like that. It's a bit, well, ABBA, they represent good songwriting, you know, like quality music, and it's all about melody, melody, melody. They just throw all these melodies at whatever they're working on. And if you compare it to the music you hear in the charts today, they're not so much about strong tunes. They're more about sounds, attitudes, choreography, production, you know.
The group finally announced the reunion and new album in September and released the singles I Still Have Faith in You and Don't Shut Me Down. The 10-track Voyage is not all the group will be releasing. They will also unveil digital avatars dubbed Avatars at a concert in London in May, resembling their 1979 selves. The holograms are the product of a years-long project designed in partnership with a special effects company of Star Wars creator George Lucas.